Facebook founder and CEO Mark Zuckerberg and TechCrunch founder, Crunch Fund founder Michael Arrington.
Okay, so you're ready? I have a few questions for you about the IPO to start. You went public on it's May 18th, and the stock has lost roughly half its value since then.
Just get right into it.
Is it awkward? No, okay. If you could have done anything differently with hindsight, would you have?
Well, you know, I mean, the performance of the stock has obviously been disappointing, right? And we care about our shareholders. And the commitment that we made is that we're going to execute this mission of making the world more open and connected, and we're going to do the things that we think are going to build value over the long term. And, you know, over the next 3 to 5 years, I think the biggest question that is on everyone's minds that will determine at least our performance over that period is really going to be how well we do with mobile. And, you know, we've been in this quiet period for the last 6 months or so, you know, since right up to the time when we were getting started with the IPO, and a lot of stuff has changed since then. I mean, 6 months ago on mobile, you know, we hadn't launched our new set of apps, right? So we were still in a pretty bad place there. Apple hadn't announced the iOS integration. Literally 6 months ago, we didn't run a single ad on mobile. So, you know, I think it's easy for a lot of folks without us being out there talking about the stuff that we're doing to really underestimate how good, how fundamentally good mobile is for us. And that's one of the main things that, that, you know, this is the first time that I've really spoken since the IPO publicly, and it's one of the main things that I think is misunderstood right now is how fundamentally good it is on a bunch of different levels. So, I mean, the first is there are more users, right, obviously. The second is that per person who's using Facebook on mobile, there's more engagement and they're spending more time. And then the third is that per amount of time that people spend on mobile, we think that we're going to make a lot more money than we do on desktop too. So, you know, you can kind of go through all three of these things. I mean, number of users, it's fairly obvious. There are a lot more people who have phones than who have computers. 5 billion people in the world who have phones. The number of smartphones growing really quickly. The number of Facebook mobile users growing really quickly. On engagement, we already see that mobile users are more likely to be daily active users of Facebook than desktop users. They're more than twice as likely to use Facebook 6 out of 7 days of the week. So there's a lot that we can do there. And those stats are from before we even launched the most recent version of the iOS app, which has been a massive improvement. And since we launched that, the number of stories that people have consumed have doubled on that.
So just slow down.
Feel free to cut me off.
I want to unpack like everything you just said, but it's going to take me a while. And I don't want to cut you off.
We have 21 minutes.
But you've just said so much. And there's so much to unpack in there. But let's jump back up. I want to get rid of the IPO questions first, and then it's interesting how much you talk about mobile, though.
Uh-huh.
And then we're going to talk a lot more about that.
Go for it.
But you know, when you went public, you said, we don't build services to make money. We make money to build great services.
Yeah.
So my response is, wow, you really meant that. And let's talk a little bit about that.
You said I did mean that.
It seems like you really meant it.
We really mean that. You know, the statement we don't build services to make money. We make money to build better services. Really goes to the heart of the philosophy that we have in running the company. And you know, there's no doubt we are a mission-driven company. I mean, we exist and we wake up in the morning, and the thing that gets us excited is making the world more open and connected and the things that we're doing to build that. But you know, you can't just focus on that, right? I mean, since the beginning of building Facebook, one of the core things that I've learned is that, you know, in order to do this, we have to build a great team. And in order to build a great team, you know, the best people want to work on a mission that they believe in, but they also want to make a bunch of money, right? And in order to do that, you have to build a great business. We want to build a platform, right? In order to build a platform, we need to build tools that are going to make it so that developers can build the things that they want and make a bunch of money. And in order to do that, we need to have a business model that works for them and incentivizes them to want to work with us. Advertisers produce a lot of the content, right? I mean, a lot of what people do on Facebook is around pages. That content is in the system because advertisers get a good ROI working with Facebook. So building a mission and building a business go hand in hand. And it is definitely true that the primary thing that makes me excited about what we're doing is the mission. But I also think that from the very beginning, we've had this healthy understanding, which is that we need to do both. And we're about doing both. And that's a key part of understanding the philosophy that we have.
Okay.